Hello students, I hope you all are fine. Today we will be learning how to balance a chemical equation. Today we will learn how to balance a chemical equation. As you can see, I have written a chemical equation over here. Mercury reacts with oxygen. What is formed? Mercury oxide. Ag stands for mercury and O stands for oxygen. Okay, the part that is before the arrow, can be also known as reactants. The part that is before the arrow is known as reactants, and the part that is after the arrow is known as product. Okay? Now see, this reactants part can also be taken as LHS. What? LHS. And the product side can be taken as RHS. Now see, in the LHS side, that is left hand side, what is there? Mercury is there and oxygen is there. So let us write, mercury is there and oxygen is there. Okay, in the RHS side, again mercury is there and oxygen is there. Now see, mercury has how many atoms? 1. Oxygen has how many atoms? 2. Here, mercury oxide. Mercury has how many atoms? 1. Oxygen has how many atoms? 1. Now, can you see mercury is balanced? Mercury 1, mercury 1. Oxygen 2, oxygen 1. Are they balanced? They are not balanced. We have to balance it now. So, to make oxygen 2 over here, if we put 2 here, that means this 2 will be going for the mercury also, and this 2 will stand for the oxygen also. That means mercury will turn to 2 and oxygen also will turn to 2. That means 2 into 1, 2, 2 into 1, 2. Okay? Now, here it's 1 and here it's 2. They are not balanced. We have to balance this side also. So, to make this mercury 2, if we put 2 over here, 2 into 1 will become 2. Now you see, mercury how much we are having here? 2. Mercury, how much we are having here? 2. That means LHS is equal to RHS. Now see the oxygen part. 2 atoms. Here also 2 atoms. That means mercury is also balanced as well as oxygen is also balanced. That means our equation is balanced up. Now we'll take another chemical equation and we'll try to solve it out. Here you see Al stands for aluminium and Cl stands for chlorine, and what is formed? Aluminium chloride. Now see, in the LHS side, we are having aluminium and chlorine. Done. Here RHS side, we are again having aluminium and chlorine. Now you see here, in aluminium how many atoms are there? Only 1. In chlorine 2 are there. In aluminium only 1 is there, in chlorine 3 is there. You might be having a doubt. So 3 is written here. Why is this 3 only for chlorine? The part that is written below, stands for this part, chlorine part. Okay? Now see, aluminium 1, balance, chlorine 2, chlorine 3, they are not balanced. That means we have to balance this chlorine part. If we put 3 over here, 3 2s are 6. If we put 2 over here, 2 3s are 6. Our chlorine is balanced now. But when I have written 2 over here, that means these 2 is standing for aluminium also. 2. But here 1 is there. If you write 2 over here, it will become 2. Understood? Now we will learn another chemical equation. Let us see. In this equation, Zn stands for zinc, HCl hydrochloric acid, ZnCl2 zinc chloride, and H2, that is hydrogen. Again, see the in the LHS part, what is there? Zn, that is zinc. HCl, H for hydrogen, Cl, chlorine. Again, RHS, Zn, Cl2, and H2. Done? Now we'll see the number of atoms. In zinc, how many atoms are there? Only one. In hydrogen, one. In chlorine, one. Okay? In zinc, one. In chlorine, two. In hydrogen, two. By seeing only, you can see zinc is already balanced. Zinc is already balanced. Chlorine, it's not balanced. Hydrogen is not balanced. Now, first of all, let us see hydrogen. Let us see hydrogen. Hydrogen 2 here, but only 1 here. If you write 2 here, 2 into 1, it will become 2. Hydrogen is balanced. Okay? Now, when I write 2 over here, this 2 is for hydrogen also. This 2 is for chlorine also. That means our chlorine will also become 2. Now you can see hydrogen is also balanced. Now you can see over here our hydrogen is balanced as well as chlorine's 2, 2. Okay, and see our zinc is also 1, here also 1. Here this equation is balanced. Again, we are taking a different equation. Here, Na stands for sodium, O2 stands for oxygen. What we are forming? Sodium oxide. Again, we need to balance this equation. Again, we will take LHS. In the LHS, what is there? Na, that is sodium, O2, that is oxygen. Okay? In the RHS side, again, Na2, that is sodium, O stands for oxygen. Now, see here. In this equation, in the LHS side, sodium, how many atoms are there? Only one is there, no? So we write 1 over here. Oxygen, how many atoms are there? Only 2. 2. Sodium, this is the sodium part. Sodium, how many atoms are there? 2. Oxygen, only 1. Done? Here, sodium 1, here sodium 2, not balanced. Here, oxygen 2, here oxygen 1. That means none of them are balanced. So, we need to first of all let us see the oxygen part. Let us see the oxygen part. Oxygen 2 over here, 2, oxygen 1. So, if you write 2 over here, if you write 2 over here, this oxygen will become 2. But sodium is already having 2, no? Again, we are writing 2 over here, that means 2 2s are 4. Sodium will become 4. Sodium will become 4. Now, see. Our oxygen is balanced now. Oxygen, here also 2. Here also 2. That means LHS is equal to RHS. But in case of sodium, here only 1, here 4. If you write 4 over here, 4 into 1, 4. Now see, our sodium is also balanced. 4 over here, 4 over here. That means 4 equal to 4, 2 equal to 2. LHS equal to RHS. That means our chemical equation is balanced. We almost done. This is the last chemical equation that we will be balancing. Here you see K2O means what? Potassium oxide. K2O stands for potassium oxide. K stands for potassium and O stands for oxygen. Again, we take the LHS side. In the LHS, what is there? K2, that is potassium, and O, that is oxygen. Okay? RHS side, K for potassium, O for oxygen. In the potassium, how many atoms are there? 2 are there. In the oxygen, only 1. Potassium, 1. Oxygen, 2. Potassium, 1. Potassium, 2. Potassium, 1. They are balanced over. They are not balanced. If I put 2 over here, it will become 2. They are balanced. Potassium is balanced now. Okay? Now see the oxygen part. Oxygen 1, oxygen 2. Since oxygen 2 is there, I have to make it 2. So if I give 2 over here, that means our oxygen is becoming 2. That means this 2 is for this also. This 2 is for this also. Now,
When I say this 2 is for this also, that means our potassium is becoming 4, 2 into 2, 4. Our potassium is becoming 4 now. Yes or no? That means we have to change this one to 4. Since here it is 4, we have to change this one to 4 now. So our chemical equation is now balanced. See, potassium 4, potassium 4, oxygen 2, oxygen 2. Our equation is balanced. So with this, we have come to the end of this topic. I hope you have understood.